Hey, what is up? I hope you're doing so well tonight. I'm so excited. Tonight, I'm gonna be talking, and in fact, man, I haven't done a Supreme Performance TV in a while because I've been doing some other cool things and working on some other fun projects on the side with some of my partners, and it's just been an exciting time in the life of Supreme Performance. But I am so excited because tonight I'm gonna be jamming with Lori McNeil. And so I met Lori just a couple, oh, and it looks like she's watching. I can add her in just a moment. I met Lori a couple of weeks ago, actually probably about a month now, and Lori is an incredible woman. And let's go ahead and actually get her rocking to be on here. Lori has been speaking across the country for a number of years now as a best-selling book author. And so I thought, how cool would it be for the folks that follow me, that are entrepreneurs and that are making their way as people trying to make a difference and really impact people's lives, to be speaking with somebody who does just that. So, in fact, Lori speaks at colleges. There she is. What is up, Miss Lori?
Hi, how are you?
I'm so stinking great. I'm so stinking great. I'm so excited that you're here. And in fact, that your people get a chance to check you out tonight as well. I know I saw on my post about tonight that a number of people were really excited to see you. So this is really exciting. I love it.
I'm excited to be here. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely, absolutely. And in fact, that's what I was just saying as you were coming on was for Supreme Performance TV, it's such a high value of mine to have people on who are truly living at the highest level of performance and doing it in a sustainable way where they're making a really big impact for people that they get to speak with. So I'm beyond honored to have you on tonight, Lori. And with that, actually, I would love to just dive right in. How's that sound?
Absolutely.
Do it. Okay, cool. So one of the things I always like to ask on here as we get started is obviously now, Lori of today is speaking all across the country and selling, best-selling books. Now I'm thinking for somebody who is part of my audience who is either a new entrepreneur or somebody who's been at it for maybe 2 to 5 years and is really just starting to pick up some speed and some momentum, but wants to eventually be in a place that you are, I'd love to hear a little bit more about your origin story or what really brought you to the place that you're at now.
Wow. Well, thank you for that introduction. I have a very diverse background, and you and I have spoken about it a little bit, Matthew, but it's kind of crazy, really, to be honest. And I think I have a true entrepreneurial heart and spirit, and always have throughout my whole life. So it's led me in many different directions, many different adventures, but I've lived this life that have really intertwined both business and education in pretty much everything I've ever done from the time I was a small child. And so then just with each experience, with each new year, my passion and my desire and my focus really just got clearer and clearer and clearer. So I actually grew up traveling a lot as a small child, and really practiced more or less my entrepreneurial endeavors and ideas and all these things as a very young child. I actually used to make barrettes for Christmas bazaars when I was a really young girl. Had a great time at that. So that taught me a lot about the market, even when it came to colors and style and talking to people and what people were interested in, and just all of those things, even as a first grader. I was actually doing that in the first grade. And then at different points, I actually had a friend of mine and I, we had a jewelry business where we'd make special sports jewelry for sports teams. And then I had a different business. My sister and I actually in high school, actually kind of young junior high, early high school, had a hot dog stand. And I actually remember making my first business proposal. And I remember at that time thinking I was going to buy all my equipment for $3,500. And I remember as a young teen thinking $3,500 is a lot of money.
Million.
But I was then taking just that next step as an entrepreneur and learning about business and about people and about the market. And to my surprise, as an 11-year-old, 12-year-old around in there, I actually was able to earn back my first $3,500 loan and then, you know, add profits on top of that much, much quicker than I anticipated, of course, because as a young 11, 12-year-old, $3,500 just seemed like a lot of money, and I thought it was going to take me forever to pay back. So that was a huge learning experience as far as really learning how to price product and really learning why I wanted to do this. And of course, I started out just wanting to buy school clothes and that kind of thing. And it really grew into a passion for people and a passion for business. And so I actually did that for three different seasons in the summer. And I learned a lot about going to the people and not necessarily expecting the people to come to you. I learned a little bit about marketing and a little bit about location and all these different things through that experience. And then as an entrepreneur, just things just kind of evolved, you know, as I got older and got into higher level leadership positions in both the private sector and in government and in just kind of a variety of different ways. So all the while I was building my leadership skills and my entrepreneur and my business skills, I was also developing my education skill set as well. So those of you who know me know that I'm very passionate about business and I'm also very passionate about education. So all of these things really, really had an amazing synergy my whole life to bring me to where I am today. And on the education side, I actually am formally trained as an educator as well. And then many different certifications that fall under that and whatnot. And I've actually taught in several countries across the world. Wow. And in that, I actually then developed not only the deeper focus for teaching and what kind of drives people and triggers people to learn the way that they do and that those mindset shifts, but also developed a passion for writing. And for writing and for research and not being afraid to dig deeper and deeper and deeper into problem solving and into critical thinking skills across the board. So as I was developing myself as an entrepreneur and as a business leader, I was also digging a lot deeper into developing my writing skills. So wow. The history with that is that I was kind of the nerdy kid in school that loved writing projects. I loved research and writing project. I loved speaking in front of my class. Those were my favorite parts really about school. And those are usually the parts that people hate the most. Yeah. So it was kind of funny. I couldn't wait for class presentations and book reports and, you know, all that kind of stuff. So it's kind of funny. So in that process, I actually would write short stories. I would do creative writing. I spent a time where I would write poetry for a while. And then as I got older, I actually then became an author, and I actually published, I have a couple of children's books that I published. And then as my skills and focus, you know, continued on in my journey, I actually then wrote and published my own business books as well. So very diverse background. These two worlds have absolutely come together beautifully for me. And I am loving what I do. I'm very passionate about what I do. So I travel the country teaching business and teaching business skills and helping entrepreneurs grow and really helping them have those mind shifts and those aha moments that they need in order to shift gears in a completely different direction than they ever thought possible. So because I have a strong business background, experientially and in my formal education, and I have a strong education background, both experientially and in my formal education, I'm able to really work with people on a deeper level to find out where they are, where they want to be, and really help them bridge that gap between the strategies and the action steps needed truly in order to move them from wherever they are to where they want to be and be able to see that process and work with them through that process in order to come to those outcomes and those results that they're after, that they've really been wanting. And some people get stuck for years And I have had amazing, amazing breakthroughs in working with me. And as a as an entrepreneur and as an educator, I love what I call those light bulb moments when someone has just been struggling so much for so long, and that breakthrough happens and you literally can see it in their eyes. And it's just, oh my goodness, you just know that they got it. There's something in their brain that just triggered that will set them and launch them in a completely different direction in a way that their life will forever be changed because they've had a mind shift change. They've had new skills, new knowledge poured into them. There's been that click action, that light bulb moment that happens, and it's not possible for them to ever think the same way or to be the same way. Who they are is starting to shift, if not completely shift. And so that's exciting for me to know that someone's life has forever been changed, either personally or professionally. And I really work within both of those realms, personal and professional. You know, a lot of people try to separate those two things. I hear a lot of people say, you know, leave your life at the door. And I really don't believe that. I believe that we are who we are, and everything that makes up who we are in our tools and our toolbox, I like to call it. So everything that is in our background, good, bad, or indifferent, everything that's in our experience, everything that that just really, really makes us unique in who we are, those things are to be embraced. Those things are to be celebrated, and those things are to be used as strong tools for moving us forward in the direction that we want to go. So I love helping people identify what some of those things are, some of those things that make them unique, their passion, their vision, all of those different things, and not focus on the competition. So you can do market research and you can do, you know, all of the different due diligence and the data for your industry and what, and pay attention to the things you need to pay attention to. But one of the things that I love helping people to realize is that everything that they have in their toolbox makes them who they are. So they need to dig deep into who they are and understand how to leverage their uniqueness and who they are so that then they can essentially be more successful in business and know how to leverage more aspects of who they are. Because there really is this business wellness, this business balance that has to happen internally and externally, both in the personal world and in their profession, in their career, in their vision, and what they're wanting to accomplish in life. Too many people try to separate those two things, and then they're stuck and they're frustrated and they're trying to figure out why maybe they're a different person at work than they are at home with their family. And the truth is that you need to embrace who you are and really understand the essence of who you are and what makes you you. And I think that when you have that mind shift, really, and really, really identifying with who you are, you start to see the world in a completely different way, and opportunities really almost start to surface because you're viewing things differently and you're leveraging the internal aspects that make you unique. And when you have that mind shift, you automatically start to move in a completely more successful, healthier direction because you're not focused on the skills that you don't have. You're not focused on the knowledge that you still maybe need to gain. You're not focused on the competition that you see in your friends and your family or within your industry, whatever that may look like. So I always encourage people, take your focus off of the competition and focus on you. Focus on what you have to offer that makes you unique, that makes you this amazing, dynamic business person in all aspects of your life, and really focus on what that looks like, because you can have two people in the same industry, the same type of business, and maybe a lot of similarities. But the way that they view solutions, the way that they view their industry, the way that they move forward, their whole mindset is going to be vastly different because of those tools that are in their unique toolbox that no one else can replicate. You can try, you can definitely look around you and say, you know, I would like to develop those skills. I would like to develop, you know, more knowledge in this area or whatever, but never let those things keep you from moving forward and actually taking action in the skill set or in the knowledge base that you currently have. And I think moving forward while you increase yourself in the ways that you want to is definitely a key part of success. I see so many people get so stuck and so bogged down into thinking that they have to be at a certain knowledge level in order to be viewed as the expert, or they have to have a degree, or they have to have letters behind their name, or they have to, you know, there's all these things. I don't have a huge following yet, so who's gonna listen to me? You know, I hear all these different things all the time. And the truth is, you have to start. Start with what you have right now today and just start. Don't get sucked into the whole vortex of, you know, paralysis by analysis. I just see that happening so much with so many different things. Or I don't have enough money to move forward with my idea. Right. Or, you know, it's just amazing. Once you gain that clear vision and passion and purpose in your life, you start to see things very, very, very differently. And you start to attract different opportunities, and you start to attract different people in your life. And when you decide that you're going to move forward and take those action steps with the tools that you currently have, and your life starts to change, this is what I love. You're no longer chasing after your vision. Your vision actually starts to pull you. And it's very, very exciting when that shift happens. And you'll notice it. When an entrepreneur goes through this process and they do kind of the tough work, they reach a point to where they start to notice that things are a little bit different. And they might feel a little bit like they're on a rat wheel, you know, as that shift starts to play out. But that's awesome. That is an awesome, awesome point to journey alongside entrepreneurs, because it's exciting. You know that amazing things are about to happen, and that if they just continue on in that direction and not be afraid to try new things, not be afraid to try new strategies, not be afraid to take action, that they're going to end up in an amazing, amazing point toward their goals in ways that they never thought possible. So I always want to encourage people, don't let fear hold you back. Don't let people or the negative influences in your life hold you back. Don't think that you don't have the right tools to get started. You know, there's so many things that people kind of get up in their head a little bit too much. And so then that's why they take so long, you know, to even start an idea. And what happens is, once you actually make that decision to start, just start anywhere, just start, then you actually then can problem solve differently in a way that you wouldn't be able to, and literally sometimes see the solutions, because you're not in that process yet. So it's not possible for you to see all of the solutions in how to move forward when you don't engage in that process. So I always encourage someone, it doesn't matter where you start. Don't worry about being perfect. Just make a decision and start and move forward. Mm. Some of our most successful people in our world and in our culture today have so many stories about how they, and I don't like to call them failures even, because there's so much that you can learn out of each thing, but they have so many challenging stories that are in their past and in their history. And the truth is, they learned so much about each one of those that they would not have been able to problem solve in the right way had they not been in the mud and the gunk in the process of actually seeing things play out and seeing possibilities and solutions, you know, every day sometimes. So to not let fear hold you back, and to not be afraid to dive into that process of figuring out, what are your goals? What's your purpose? You know, what's your deeper reason why? Your deeper reason why has to be more than just seeing your name hanging on your own shingle outside your building. It has to be deeper than just the paycheck. You know, it's got to be so much more than that. There's got to be something that gets you out of bed in the morning, that drives you, no matter how tired you are, no matter what challenges might be going on in your life. You've got to have that deeper purpose and that deeper why that's way, way, way more long term. Yeah. So I always encourage people, don't be afraid to do that deeper foundational work, but at the same time, don't allow it to keep you back. Mm-hmm. Don't think, oh, I've got to do all this work before I can even get started. Okay. No, that's a process that you just dive right into and you do. And so all of these things that are tools in my toolbox, I actually am excited to teach and to coach on and to really, really communicate those important things in my books. So I actually just finished an 8-month collaborative project. Woo! That I'm super excited about. This is actually the first official public announcement that I'm making about this. So I actually co-authored a book with Kevin Harrington of Shark Tank. He's also the founder of As Seen on TV, amazing entrepreneur. He's an amazing man. I feel very, very blessed and fortunate to have been working with his team for the last several months on this project. So Kevin and I are actually flying from different directions and meeting in California here in the next couple of weeks. And we have a 2-day media and book launch event on this project. So I'm very, very excited to make this first public announcement on your show, Matthew. So thank you so much. And in that book, I actually talk a little bit about my history, about my challenges, about the tools and tips that I've learned over the years as an entrepreneur and as an educator that have led to the success that I've experienced, and in a lot of things that I teach every single day, whether that's in a formal classroom setting or whether that's in a coaching session. Everything I do is about really trying to equip other people to be more successful. So if I have taught a class, a seminar, coached someone, worked with someone in a business to equip them to carry on that success, then I've done my job as a coach. I've done my job as an educator. I do not want people to be dependent on me, but long-term, because that's not going to serve them well, you know, long-term in their own goals. So I love working with people who are serious about their long-term growth and success, and they're not afraid to dive into that deeper work. And then honestly, I'm like a parent to all of my clients. It's like a bittersweet when it's time for them to go forward and carry out, you know, the tools that they've learned in the process and working with me. So it's very, very exciting. I've been doing this. I've been in education and in business for over 20 years. So I love what I do. I'm passionate about what I do. It's truly what gets me out of bed in the morning, helping other people accomplish their goals and be successful so that they don't have to keep spinning their wheels over and over and over, doing the same thing, expecting a different result. And that can be in their thought process, you know, thinking the same way, or that can be in their actions, but in all aspects of their life, personally and professionally, how can we get to that overall business wellness and that overall business balance that leads to greater long-term success? And that's truly what I'm passionate about and what I do every single day.
So awesome. I love it. I love it. And in fact, we even are kind of coming up on time. So this is perfect because we just got so much. That was such a beautiful download, Lori. So I would love to hear, what's the best way for people to get in touch with you, to learn out more, and even to eventually buy your book when it comes out? How do we get more in touch with you?
Absolutely. So I'm doing the book launch in California, but the actual book does not hit the shelves until about late May, early June.
Okay.
So it's definitely something to be watching for, and all over my social media, more and more announcements and information will be coming out about that. So LoriMcNeil.com is my website. I am all over social media, so you can connect with me in a variety of ways, but definitely please connect with me. Tell me your story. Let's have a conversation. Let's figure out how we can get you from wherever you are to where you want to be that leads to that long-term success that you're after in overall balance in your life. You can connect with me on Facebook. You can definitely send me a friend request that way. You can send me a private message. You can contact me through my website, LoriMcNeil.com. I do have a YouTube channel. I'm on Twitter. I'm all over the place. So there's lots of ways to connect with me. And I definitely invite people. Definitely say hi, if anything, and connect with me all over social media. But Facebook is actually a really, really good way to connect with me. Super, super easy, super fast. Like I said, send me a friend request. Be a part of my active feed that's on there. Private message me. You can email me. My email and all my contact information is actually on my website if you'd rather contact me that way. And again, that's LoriMcNeil.com.
Beautiful. Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Lori, for joining us. And such a pleasure. I'm super excited to just continue to see all of the work that you're doing continue to unfold and in your clients' lives as well. So thank you so much, Lori.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me. It was an honor to be on your show and make that announcement for the first time.
Of course, Lori. Awesome. Thanks so much. Everyone else, have a fantastic night. And here is to your supreme performance. Thanks so much, Lori. We'll see you soon.
Thank you so much. Bye.